During his emancipation address on August 1st, Prime Minister Philippe J. Pierre revealed that he had received reports about potential layoffs by employers in response to the upcoming implementation of the minimum wage. He urged employers to collaborate with the government in order to enhance the living standards of workers. During his speech at the annual general meeting of the SLP Vieux North constituency last Saturday, he reiterated his apprehensions, alleging that the United Workers' Party was orchestrating a plan to terminate workers for political motives.
In August, we had a minimum wage for the people of St. Lucia, historical. Only a Labour Party government can have a minimum wage, for the people of St. Lucia. And they are planning and plotting with some people to lay off workers because of the minimum wage. The United Workers Party planning and plotting the people to lay off workers. But when we did it the first time, when we announced it, and you know, again, I do things the right way. I never announced no minimum wage until I got the minimum wages and the Equal Minimum Wages Commission to have all their meetings, meet all the businessmen, meet all the people, and they're the ones, not me, not the cabinet. You can ask them, Musa was there, Wayne is there, Ibo is there, Jeremiah is there. They're the ones who said what the minimum wage was for the people of St. Lucia.
Employers have until October 1st, 2024 to adjust their systems and ensure employee remuneration reflects the minimum wage of $6.52 per hour, the equivalent of $1,130 per month. Approximately 13,000 workers are set to get a pay hike. The Prime Minister once again urged employers to do right by the country's workers.
And they are plotting. They are plotting to destroy you, to destroy St. Lucia. That's what they're plotting to do. But only Labour, only Labour, only the Labour Party government could have a minimum wage. And I want to tell the business people, do not allow themselves to be used by opportunistic politicians. Give the people their just wages. And the people must work for these just wages. A fair day's work for a fair day's pay. That's what the Labour Party stands for.
During last week's pre-cabinet press briefing, Labour Minister Dr. Virginia Albert Poyot emphasized that the minimum wage would be separate from any incentives, bonuses, commissions or service charges that employees earn. The Labour Minister also mentioned that the minimum wage commission's term had been extended in order to allow it to monitor the minimum wage implementation process, including any layoffs due to the measure. For the DBS News World, I am Zin Romulus.